Conservationists are calling it a great day for the ocean, expanding the monument ahead of his trip to Hawaii and Midway Atoll. Elisa Arevalo follows up with more. Elisa.
Marissa, the expansion brings the total protected area of the monument to more than 582,000 square miles. Supporters say this isn't just a victory for them, but for future generations to come. The largest marine protected area on the planet is officially in Hawaiian waters.
We hope that it's an example for the future of all leaders of all the worlds of why it's so important to protect the natural world.
Originally 50 nautical miles, the expanded Papahanaumokuakea Monument now covers an area more than four times the size of California. Researchers say the expansion was needed following a number of scientific studies.
We continue to discover new species up there in the monument. We realize now that the larvae of coral reef organisms expand well beyond the 50-mile limit. A lot of the food web interactions involve areas well outside the existing previous monument.
Supporters praise President Obama for making, quote, a bold move that they say brought the indigenous voice to the national level.
It elevates the spiritual, cultural well-being of our people.
I think better decisions will come about for any kind of environmental, biocultural challenges that face any other country in the world.
They say it's not only a win for science, but a gift for the keiki.
And they're the ones that are going to carry the burden, so let's help them to become now the keepers of this special place.
And with the World Conservation Congress just around the corner, the coalition feels the tone for the convention has been set.
To rethink about how we manage things, to rethink about how we value indigenous knowledge, to rethink about what we can do out of the box to solve today's and tomorrow's problems.
Supporters say ideally the expansion would cover even more of the ocean, but for now international jurisdiction restricts that. Elisa Arevalo, KHON 2 News.
Elisa, thank you. Now, despite the benefits to the ecosystem, some say they're still opposed to the expansion, partly because it'll affect business for local fishermen and the cost to enforce the ban.
And now we have a very efficient fishing operation, and that's going to be greatly impacted when they can't fish in the waters around Hawaii, because I feel very strongly that the state is in a better position to decide what is good for the ocean rather than federal officials.
Opponents also argue that the expansion could hurt your wallet, since prices will likely rise now that fishermen will have to go farther out to catch fish.